Hi friends, this is Prithvi. Welcome to Techie Taiki. Today I will show you retro game emulation on Android. This is a continuation of my last video where I was unboxing Orange Pi PC. I have also shown in that video how to play retro games with gamepad installed. I installed few games from Google Play Store. And I also promised to come back with one more video related to this Android OS for Orange Pi PC. I was actually testing this operating system for last few days and came up with this video. If you have not seen my previous video on Orange Pi PC unboxing, I'll leave a link below description and you can check that out. When I first installed on Android operating system for on Orange Pi PC, I downloaded the image from Orange Pi PC's website, and when I flashed it to the SD card and booted it for the first time, the operating system was Android KitKat. However, when I connected it to the internet, I got a software upgrade. Both the interface and the operating system got upgraded. And I am not sure which version of Android it is running now because the settings section after upgrading got locked. That will not stop our work anyways. I will be now testing few retro game emulation on Android. Stay tuned. So here is the homepage of the OS which is available on Orange Pi's official website. This is the OS image for Android which is available on Orange Pi website for Orange Pi PC. On installing it, I just realized on the app section there are a lot of retro game emulators. So I just wanted to try it. So as you can see here goes the Game Boy emulator, Game Boy Color, Game Gear, Sega Genesis. On the app tray on the second page, I will show it to you. On the second page, we have NES, SNES, N64 and PlayStation. I will be trying four emulators and show it to you the performance. Stay tuned. So friends, let's start with Game Gear. Whenever we download something in Android, it generally stays at the download folder. So the app is this emulator is asking for the ROM. So as it was saved in my download section, I just selected Mega Man. So the game is starting now. As you have seen on the top left hand side corner, the D-pad is there, whereas on the right hand side corner below there is the like A and B switch 1, 2, and the select button is in the middle. I know it is very difficult to play game using mouse or keyboard, but you can configure the joystick also. You can configure keyboard as well. That will give us convenience to play this game. So I will be quickly configuring my gamepad because it is difficult for me to play with mouse. Stay tuned. As you can see, the virtual keypad is on. We can switch it off and play this game with gamepad alone. So the configuration part, I'll just put it on fast forward mode. Now that you're done with configuration, let's start this game. This is Mega Man release 93-94. So in terms of quality, I don't feel any it's not lagging anywhere in terms of both picture and sound. This emulator is working fine, I can say. let's try some other emulators as well. Let's try the emulator that is for NES now. I will be removing the virtual keypad that is coming on screen. It is very irritating. So I clicked off the virtual keypad from here. So see, it is not coming on screen. We can enjoy the game. Let's try SNES also, SNES emulator. Now let's try the Ultimate N64. Let's see how it performs. Looking at the intro only, I can tell you it started way better than RetroPie or Recall Box on Raspberry Pi.
But the only problem is this emulator is in Chinese language and I am not able to change it to English. So not able to configure joystick or keyboard accordingly. That is the only problem. Friends, if you like my video, please like, share and subscribe. You can comment as well. Thank you.